Say it's your first day at a new job. Maybe you're nervous or jittery. You want to make a good impression. Those feelings are pretty normal, and they may actually help you be more alert and careful. But after a few weeks, once you're used to the job and you know your co-workers, that nervousness usually diminishes, right? Well, for some people, that initial anxiety is really high and it stays really high over time. For those people, the fear of being judged negatively by new people might be so daunting that it affects their ability to do their job well. In fact, even the idea of having to be somewhere where they may be scrutinised by others might make them not want to do the job in the first place. This describes social anxiety disorder. It's unclear what causes social anxiety disorder, but it's thought to be a combination of genetic and environmental factors, like having a close relative with social anxiety disorder or being exposed to neglect and abuse. The Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, or DSM-5, defines social anxiety disorder as causing individuals to fear acting in a certain way that might make them get judged, and it can cause anxiety that interferes with their normal routine as well as their relationships. And what's more is the fear of anxiety is persistent, lasting for 6 or more months. Usually, social anxiety disorder causes distress for individuals in specific social situations or circumstances. For example, one person might get really anxious when making small talk with acquaintances or meeting new people, whereas another person might get performance anxiety and not feel able to give a presentation or give a toast at a friend's wedding. Social anxiety disorder is an ego-dystonic condition, meaning that people who have the disorder usually understand that their anxiety is unwarranted. But unfortunately, that awareness can cause more anxiety because they'll fear that others can tell how anxious they are. Sometimes, individuals might worry that they may be having physical symptoms, like trembling or blushing, that others may notice and judge them for. Sometimes the anxiety can get so severe that it causes something called derealization, meaning that a person might feel spaced out and may be less able to recognise their surroundings. In order to reduce their social inhibitions, some people with social anxiety use drugs and alcohol, and that can lead to dependency and addiction. The DSM-5 states that in order to make a diagnosis of social anxiety disorder, the fear or avoidance shouldn't be due to the effects of a medication or due to another condition. And that's important, because there are key features of social anxiety disorder that overlap with other conditions. For example, in generalized anxiety disorder, individuals have anxiety, but it's not limited to being judged in a social context. The anxiety is usually broader, and it includes non-social concerns, like finances or physical safety. Another example is agoraphobia, where people avoid public places for fear of being trapped and not being able to escape, just in case something embarrassing happens or if they begin to panic. But in agoraphobia, the fear is less about being judged and more about being trapped in a crowd and not able to escape. Treatment usually involves psychotherapy, medication, or a combination of the two. If it's psychotherapy, cognitive behavioural therapy is recommended, since it teaches a person new ways of thinking and behaviours to help them in being around others. Antidepressants are the most common choice of medication. Specifically, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, or SSRIs, serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors, or SNRIs, as well as benzodiazepines and beta blockers. SSRIs help regulate serotonin levels in the brain, while SNRIs help regulate serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine to manage anxiety. Benzodiazepines are psychoactive drugs that have a relaxing effect, and beta blockers can help ease the physical symptoms of performance anxiety. Though medication can be effective in the short term, cognitive behavioural therapy has more advantages in the long term due to the potential of unwanted side effects. Alright, so as a quick recap, people with social anxiety disorder have heightened anxiety about acting in a way or showing symptoms of anxiety that will be negatively scrutinised by others. Anxiety that is restricted only to performance is a specific type of social anxiety. The anxiety is almost always present in a particular social situation, and it's severe enough that it interferes with the normal course of life.
Hi everyone, Sarah here. Thanks for watching that video on social anxiety disorder. a really important and often not very well understood topic, which is, you know, vital to be aware of whether you're working in a psychiatric field or as a medical clinician or even as a member of the public. It's important to be aware because it obviously has a huge impact on people's lives. And I hope we help to shed a bit more light on the subject for you. The script was written by Simone. It was edited by Rishi, Todd and Kathy. And I did the illustration and the voiceover. And then the whole video was edited by Sam. So big thanks to the team who made it happen. If you like that video and you like other videos on the YouTube channel, then make sure that you head over to osmosis.org. We've got a whole load more resources which are super useful for medical school, so definitely worth checking that out. Also, please feel free to check us out on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and leave us some reviews and some feedback, and we'd love that. Thanks a lot. Till next time, bye!